Bengaluru is upset about a plan to cut down over 33,000 trees for a new road. A city that's already grappling with traffic jams has to prioritize trees or a new ring road. Many citizens say trees. Now, the Bengaluru Development Authority has proposed an 8-lane ring road, which is going to connect Tumkur Road to Hosur Road, forming a closed ring connecting the nice road in the city. Now, what's really upset people is that the number of trees proposed to be cut keeps changing. The BDA had earlier said that only 200 to 500 trees would be cut. Contradicting this, a Horticulture and Forest Department report said 16,685 trees would be cut. After the National Green Tribunal asked for a fresh environment assessment report, that number has gone up to over 33,000. Now, the draft environmental assessment report assesses the environmental consequence of any plan, policy, or even program. This report flags off certain issues while suggesting mitigation measures. First, the report says that the removal of trees will lead to habitat loss of Indian peafowl and disturbance of vegetation and sensitive plant communities. 9,304 trees in the TG Halli catchment area and 631 trees in the Jarakabande Reserve Forest area are proposed to be cut. A diversion of 10.12 hectares is also proposed at the reserve forest area. Now, activists say that the proposed project is in violation of the Karnataka Town and Country Planning Act.
Scheme for promoting a peripheral road needs to be reintroduced under the Town and Country Planning Act scheme, which requires 4 public hearings. And if it passes through that, then it comes to environmental clearance. We are sidestepping land use planning and rushing towards environmental clearance and claiming environmental clearance is everything. It is a small thing in the overall scheme. So in the middle of a pandemic, these people have time to promote a massive project which will destroy thousands of homes? Are they out of their minds? I mean, seriously, I think this is an insane thing.
Second, the draft EIA also says that the removal of trees in the TG Halli catchment area will affect the hydrological regime and water quality in the area. Additionally, 5 lakes and a tank all in this alignment, but the draft report suggests a 30-meter buffer zone.
Sure, it is going to do a lot of damages and everything. And there is a 9,000 tree which is coming in a catchment area. We have to look into that also. There is a catchment area where 9,000 trees are coming. So that is in a TG Halli, where the water retention and everything will happen. That we have to look into it. Even if there is something called Jarakabande forest area also comes, where the leopards and the tigers has been, the report has come and everything. The continuity or whatever it is, then the biodiversity is thriving. It has, all this has to be looked into it actually.
And third, a public hearing for citizens to voice their opinions is going to be held on the 18th of August, ironically, amidst an ongoing pandemic, with Bengaluru becoming a hotspot.
I don't know why probably the ministry has taken up this call to do it at a time which is, you know, very dangerous and also putting a lot of citizens into danger by asking them to come in. And while it is appreciated and admired that activists want to stand up, take a call, and I do know a lot of them want to go, but is it the right thing to kind of ask people to risk their lives?
We in fact got in touch with the newly appointed BDA Commissioner H.R. Mahadev and asked him why there was a discrepancy in the number of trees that were going to be cut. And he said that this study has been thoroughly done. He also went on to say that public consultation date is on the 18th of August and that social distancing rules would be followed. When asked about people who really wanted to come but cannot because of the pandemic, he said that things will have to move on and development cannot stop. So what happens now? Citizens and activists ask why there is a need to push this project now and what's the hurry? In the meantime, NGO Jatka has started an online petition with over 4,800 signatures against this proposed project. While citizens cannot protest on the streets like they used to before, they hope that online petitions will make a difference. Thanks for watching.